Here we go, getting the secret sauce out. Wake up!
What happened?
All right, Casey says if you listen to George Strait, you find out. So, Casey, this one's for you, man. We got George Strait blazing first thing in the morning. Let's go! Oh, yeah, another George Strait hit. Guys, I'm preparing for the morning. I need some energy. We're pretty tired, so I'm doing my favorite. Again, sad thing is, getting a little low on the Yeti.
I know.
That sucks. Oh. And you're out of a Magnum,
yeah,
huh?
I think I maybe have one scoop left. Maybe two. We can maybe squeeze two out of there.
Poverty.
Yeah.
Anyways, guys, so yeah, it's funny. We have all these, like, Lucky Charms, you know, like listening to George Strait. That's Casey's. Every time we go hunting, we blast George Strait in the truck. So I wanted to ask you guys, do you guys have any, like, superstitious, like, lucky hat, lucky song, like, anything? Let me know. Comment them below. I want to see what your guys' lucky charms are. Think, what's your lucky charms?
Eric, you're my lucky charm. You're not working, though.
Well, okay, we're going to get after it today, guys. Fingers crossed. Watching the freaking gas pump just go soaring. I'm dead empty. I think a full tank of gas, which was like 23, 24 gallons, lasted me like a day and a half, which was probably like $55. But hey, when I first bought this truck, 2007, gas was like $5 a gallon or more. And I was hunting down here. Dude, it was like $100 bills every time I'd fuel up. That was crazy. Yeah, here's my $100. Well, here we go again. Another walk of shame back to the truck after a unsuccessful morning hunt. What do you think?
Definitely the walk of shame. I hate the walk of shame.
We've walked a lot of walk of shames on this hunt.
It's becoming all I know.
Yeah, it's gonna change, right?
I hope so. We need some luck. We need the elk gods to shine down on us. We need something.
Yeah. We need a miracle.
We need a miracle.
We also need some breakfast.
And breakfast.
What are you gonna get?
What are you gonna get?
Dude, eggs and sausage, man, every time.
I'm gonna go pancake, bro.
Well, you get that as a bonus on the side.
Yeah, it's true. Eggs for sure. I think we're gonna eggs, pancakes, and some bacon.
He wants a sampler. So yeah, that's a wrap for another morning hunt. Guys, we're gonna make one of these episodes. It's gonna be really entertaining, I promise. There will be elk in it. We will feature a bull. There will be guns firing. And it's gonna be a good time. I can't wait for that day.
Me either.
Hopefully sooner than later, because Chad might have to leave in the next few days. We'll see. We'll see what happens.
He might stick around.
Who? Dude, you're supposed to be polite and wait.
Mm-hmm. Who, me?
I'm always getting...
Well, he's got toast. Good enough,
good.
Right?
Yeah,
so it's a free game. Here's breakfast, guys.
I'm good. I'm happy.
All about the sausage, eggs, hash browns, toast, and what'd we do? Did you add a pancake?
I added a pancake.
I had a pancake, too.
Mmm. It's so good. They're treating us right here. They're not serving breakfast, so it's after 11.
No, we were like 11:10.
They're hooking us up big time.
Well, decided to move and check out some new country. There's definitely elk in here. Look at all the tracks. This is a little chunk of a BLM I'm hunting. Looks like a good spot, so I'll most likely be spending a lot of time in here the next few days. It's got... smells like elk, but it's got pine trees, cedar trees, oak brush. It's just a really good little draw. Just walking around and seeing a lot of tracks. I'm just gonna walk around and just kind of check out the area so I make a game plan. Might be sitting here tonight, we'll see. Holy crap, I just shot a bull and dropped him. I just got off the phone with Chad, hung up the phone, looked across the draw, and two cows were there and a bull standing there. And I shot, I don't know if I hit him that first shot or not, but I had to run down here
and he stood broadside right there, and I got my bipod down and took a shot at him and dropped him. I jacked another shell, and then he got up. And then, man, I was trying to shoot through the trees. I just wanted to get another one in him, but I don't know if I hit him. I don't know if he's down up there or if he went off with the cows, but holy cow, that was intense. Oh, holy crap. On just this little piece of public land right here. Oh, that was insane. The first shot was freehand. Looking back, I wish I would have just set up my bipod, but his cows were getting super nervous. Dang it. Holy cow. I'm gonna call Chad. I gotta get on the phone and call Chad and his dad and get them both out here, see if they can come help me. That was crazy. Midday. Did not have a clue there was gonna be a bull in here. And there he was. Just looks like a good 6-point. Holy crap. He might be down up there. I don't know. But I'm gonna play it safe. See if I can call Chad and his dad and get him out here. I'll be back, guys. One sec. Here we go again, guys. Another wild ride elk hunting. I don't know why I can't catch a break. I shot at the bull freehand because his cows were getting nervous, missed, ran over the hill, found him. I put up the bipod. Guys, I have never felt so confident in taking a perfect broadside shot. I'm not kidding. I was steady. The bull was stopped. I shot. I heard the thud and it dropped him. The bull literally dropped to the ground. And I didn't hesitate to jack in another shell, and it didn't take him long and he got up. And I was shooting through the trees. I just trying to get a second shot at him. Had an opening through some branches. Freehanded it. Missed, I think. And I saw the cows run out in front of him, and he was behind the cows, struggling. Honestly, I thought any second he'd tip over. But there's no shot. I can just see his antlers. I thought he dropped. I really did. I thought he dropped. Went over there, and he's not there. So I'm gonna wait for Chad. I'm gonna wait for Chad and his dad because I need help. I need eyes. We need to track. And we gotta kill this bull. I cannot believe I've never felt so confident in a shot and had a bull stand up. I mean, disbelief, a big caliber rifle like that, I can't believe it. Why can't I catch a break on these type of things? Why can't I just get that perfect shot? It's killing me. Anyways, I'm gonna wait for Chad to get here. We're gonna go do some work. And we gotta find this bull. We've got to find this bull. Nice bull. Just looked like a really solid 6-point. Well, here we go. Met up with the A-team. These guys are now the A-team because I need their help. Like I said, guys, I am in a loss for words. I mean, now I know he's hit twice. I backtracked him a little bit. We found blood. There's numerous spots of blood like that. Not a lot. Some of it was bubbly, which was good. Might be lung blood. But he definitely came up here. Like, I saw him in this opening.
That looked like snotty blood, you know?
Yeah, that's his track.
What did you shoot him?
He went straight up this way. Yeah, that's his track. He came right here, and he went that left, broadside. That's when I shot him.
He dumped him. Climbing is what it was.
All right. We are gonna do our best. I'm gonna have my gun as we track him. And we'll give you guys updates as we go. Hopefully we just find him dead. He's gotta die. That bull's gotta die.
Yeah.
He's got multiple bullets in him.
He's a bed.
We'll find him. Holy cow, guys. This is where I dropped him. You can see where he imprinted his shins in the dirt, and look at all the blood. He went that way. Last I saw his aunt, they kind of rolled this way. But dude, I was hiking below him. He could be piled up right here.
Oh
my gosh, fingers crossed. We're gonna find this bull. I just hope it's sooner than later because I hate these track jobs. I love to track. It's fun. I love to follow blood, but not when it's my animal. Glad these guys are here to help me. Okay, we're hot on the track. Here we go.
It's done. Eric just smoked one. Woo!
That bull was hiding.
Yeah.
Right where I saw him disappear is where he's hiding. Holy cow, dude.
Dude.
We did it.
Yes. Good job, Eric, dude.
Oh my gosh. Oh. We found him. Testing. Oh my gosh. Guys, I just dropped my gun to look for blood, and I saw that bull's antlers. Guys, it's a nice 6-point bull.
Heck yeah.
It's a great bull.
Dude, that's awesome. Finally. Finally, nice elk. We got him.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
A super hard hunt so far.
relief, guys. Ooh. Now I can relax, and now I can celebrate.
Dude, that is insane.
Midday. Just checking tracks. I was gonna walk the boundary, and guys, I'll put a screenshot of this where I'm at in BLM. Again, this is why it's important to have Onyx maps.
Yeah.
We did it. One bull down. And
that's a stud,
really
dude.
Really nice 6-point. Thanks, dude. I'm so glad these guys are here.
That's a nice bull.
Wish you guys were here when I shot, dude. It was crazy.
That was unreal.
Here he is, guys. Take a look.
Yeah. Success.
Public land, open bull unit, and I'll tell you what, I was not expecting to see elk in this little piece. And that fence right there, private property. And look where he died. Just a really nice 6-point. When I saw him, I could just tell he was a mature bull. And I shot him. I know I hit him at least twice. This one high in the shoulder on his left side is the one that dropped him, but we haven't been able to flip him over to see exactly where it hit. Unfortunately, I think I just hit too high. This is a great way to end my hunt, so I'm super happy. I can't wait to take care of him and hunt with these guys. So take a look, guys. A little short on the G1s. He's not a really, really old bull, but he came in here and swept the cows. He had the cows. Just a nice 6-point.
Eric's bull. Nice 6-point.
What a
dude.
Season, man. I've shot an antelope and two elk.
This guy's on fire this year.
That Weatherby did the job.
Call him
man.
The elk whisperer.
These animals are tough.
This guy, yeah.
I've said it 100 times. They're so tough. There it is, a Weatherby 6.5 300. My first elk with a rifle ever in my life. I've got the Vortex Viper VHSLR scope. And look at this shot, guys. The one that dropped him. Bam, look at these. There's two here. This for sure is my one that dropped, and we're thinking this is the one we had to put him down with. But man, it must have hit the shoulder blade and just shattered his leg. His legs broke. And if we were just, you know, 5, 6, 7 inches back, kill shot through the rib cage. But that put him down and dropped him in his tracks. I cannot believe he got up. That was a tough hunt. I mean, I've only archery hunted elk. I've taken 4 with a bow. That was intense. That was way intense. Now I'm excited that I can just relax and go hunt with these guys. It's been a fun
pressure
hunt though.
Off, yeah.
Honestly, the pressure does feel a little bit off, and now we can just focus. Now that we have a guy that can just stay back in either spot or, you know, do little pushes, whatever we need to do to get Chad and his dad a bull, we're gonna try it. But we have to take care of this guy. And get him in the truck.
Backstraps, baby.
Yeah, it's nice because he's right on a fence line with the road, so couldn't ask for a better place for him to die. Nice bull. I'm really happy. Would you shoot him?
Yeah, in a heartbeat. Dude, that's awesome.
Oh yeah.
All right, guys, we're gonna get to work. But again, thanks for tagging along. I know this series was not too exciting, and I wish I could have filmed that by myself, but there was no way I was self-filming that. The cows were getting nervous and it just went down. All right, it just went down.
Yeah.
Shots. Super happy though. How cool. Finally, we got some decent footage for you guys. We got elk in our elk hunting series. Gonna do the honor of cutting the tag. Today is October 12th, I believe.
Yeah.
Let's do it. Notching the tag. And you gotta mark the sex, so male right here.
Notching the tags. It's a good feeling, isn't it?
Yeah. Feels great.
There's so much meat for the freezer.
Here we go, guys. punched my tag, my 2016 open bull rifle hunt, first elk with a gun. Thanks to Weatherby for getting me dialed up. A special thanks to Thompson Long Range and Vortex Optics. Thanks, guys, for helping me put my rifle together. Holy crap. Are we lucky to be able to get that in there? We've got cactus in the hand, ripped pants. We got him in there full body.
We got him.
We had to drag him for a little while. 1, 2, 3, hoot. 1, 2, 3, hoot. Yeah. People say fitness doesn't matter to be a hunter. Sure, maybe it doesn't to kill big bulls sometimes, but there's a lot of times where it comes in handy, like today when I had to run that elk down and shoot him. And when we had to load this. Chad's gonna be a power lifter. Mm-hmm. Change his career.
The elk power lifter.
He's in there. Okay. Guys, we're tuckered out, but we gotta get him in there. I'm gonna run to the meat locker and try to get these guys out on the hunt if there's time. So what a day, man. What a day. Like I said, when you least expect it, anything can happen. Again, I want to say thanks for following this series. I know every video isn't as entertaining as this, but I think every video on this series so far has had like a cool topic or something to learn. So I just want to say thanks for sticking in there with us and following along. I hope you guys had fun. The series is not going to end. I'm going to continue vlogging while we hunt for Chad. So stay with us. As you can see, we made it back to the cabin. All the hard work's done. I got the elk full body to the meat locker, and those guys are going to take care of it from here. But Chad and his dad, they helped me out a ton on this hunt. They helped me out a ton packing this out. It's definitely been a group effort. Chad's dad has been killing it on the dinners. So just to repay them and just say thanks, I'm going to cook them dinner. So let me show you what we got here, guys. This is my go-to meal at home. This is what I eat almost every day. And I'm really trying to eat healthy and just eating what I like anyways, all the game meat that I have. So check this out. Got some steak seasoning, some bags to put them in, olive oil for the mixture of marinade. I love to do all kinds of veggies just sauteed together. So we've got potatoes, onion, cilantro, and peppers. And look what we have here. A big chunk of elk backstrap off my bull from today. That is just a portion of one backstrap. That is a sliver of just one little backstrap, and that is going to make a lot of steaks. As you can see, that literally came right off the elk, so I'm going to have to do some trimming to trim off all the gristle and the fat and the connective tissues. But I'm gonna cook these guys up. Elk backstraps and veggies. Here's the finished product. I've got the backstrap completely cleaned up. And on the sides of the backstrap, there is some meat right here. And that's great meat. I might trim some of that to cook up, or I'll take it back to the meat locker and let them add that with the hamburger. But this stuff, guys, look at this. This is how you want a steak to look. It's not like beef where you want it all marbly and fat. This is lean, lean meat. So this elk, it doesn't get much more fresh than that. Killed today and in our bellies tonight.
Oh, awesome. Really? Yes.
You already cutting your video, huh?
Oh, yeah. Gotta get after it. I'm so tired, dude. Let me get this and eat some dinner.
Make these things dark.
And shower, and I'm passing out.
Everything's looking good. You got the potatoes and the veggies with, I think I did 4 or 5 strips of bacon. This pan, getting hot. And we got the back straps on. So we're gonna serve steak and potatoes. Dang, those look good. Just dished up Chad and his dad dinner for tonight. Mine's still cooking, but here's theirs. Look at that. Topped it with a little bit of cilantro. Chad, my man.
It's ready?
Dude, it's ready.
Dude, look at that.
This is gourmet style. I got a knife and a fork for you. You gotta take a break, man. Here's your knife and fork behind you. Let's eat dinner together. We're gonna sit down like a happy little family that we are and enjoy this meal together. I'm so happy.
You got a pop.
And we got salt and pepper, and I have dessert. If you guys follow me on Instagram, you know I'm all about that milkshake life. I went to Maverick and got a for reals for later.
I didn't know you get those to go.
Yeah, they put a top on them, dude.
What?
Put a top on them, and I got some Krispy Kreme donuts. You know I got the Krispy Kreme.
I don't know about this life. I'm not about that life. You need to be about that life.
Well, guys, that was a fun day. I'm glad we finally got some action. I wish I could have got the kill shot for you, but it was a little intense. But again, thanks for following us along. I'm going to continue to hunt and film Chad. So we're going to get him shooting a bull. I'll film that one for you. So make sure to watch tomorrow as well. Thanks again. We'll catch you later.